What's up, guys? So coming to Netflix pretty soon, and as soon as less than a month, must-see trans skateboarding documentary Stay On Board is heading to Netflix. This article is from Yahoo News. A few other outlets covered it as well, posted today. What is this that you speak of, skater informants? Apparently, Leo Baker is, in case you've been living under a rock and don't know this, but Leo Baker is a trans man. Was a woman, now identifies as a man, and has gone through a series of surgeries. But nonetheless, the main important thing here is that they used to identify as a woman and now as a man. However, the pronouns is they, them. And what's so controversial, and I think is extremely interesting, well, aside from, you know, we got to go watch it, I want to see what this is about, is that Leo is the anti-abusive, beating up on little children conversation or narrative that some people have been following. So as of now, there's been a lot of talks about men transitioning into women, therefore having an unfair advantage on competitions. Taylor Silverman, the Katori thing, there's been a few of those, and people are like, we got to stop this. But how about when you flip the roles? How about when you are a woman and you withdraw from the Olympics because you're in the women's division and you're like, well, the chances I'm gonna win or at least get a medal are extremely high. If you haven't seen Leo Baker shred, you should. I can really, really win this, but I don't feel like it's right because I identify as a man. So I have to withdraw and I don't take anything home, right? And some people may think, well, how about join the men's and then see, go against P-Rod and all these other, you know, high level dudes, the Nijas, right? The Shane O'Neills of the world. Well, I don't know if it's so black and white in the sense of, well, all your competition and your runs have been competing against women. They can't automatically transfer and say you're in the finals for the Olympics. So just in case there was a few of you thinking that way, like, I don't think that transfers, like, there's not like credits. You transfer from one college to another. But anyways, so this documentary starts off apparently when they withdraw from the Olympics and then you go from there. A few quotes from this article, they couldn't take it anymore. You know, the truth was out and they couldn't pretend they were a woman when they weren't. So there's some interesting starting points here. However, I want to know what their take is on competing. Will they ask Leo, what do you think about the Taylor Silverman situation? What do you think about trans women? I really, really hope Netflix did their due diligence and asked Leo their opinion on that subject, because that would be such a grounding point, a foundation to a lot of people's arguments. People will normally talk about this from the outside, such as myself. That's why I keep it neutral. I can't speak like I know what it feels like to be in their shoes. But if you ask Leo the anti-abusive situation, then we have something to go by. So guys, I'm just super excited. Like I said, it's going to be a very short video today. Just as an FYI heads up, there is a Netflix documentary, Stay On Board, apparently going to hit Netflix in August. There you go, August 11th. There's some private showings or the opening July 14th and 24th, but we'll all get to see it on August 11th. So I'm super hyped to get there. I want to see it already. And it'll add a lot of context to where some of these people are coming from. Maybe they are abusive. Maybe they're keeping it legit. I don't know. We'll see soon. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Catch you guys on the next one.